Hello, this is the middle of August 2021 and finally we can start working at the roof. During the winter we only had over the wheat boards placed waterproofing membrane, and over those I placed geotextile to protect the waterproofing and some straw. And now we can take it all out. We'll place over the wood boards, we'll place straw bales, very well compacted, that most likely will come in 2 days time, and then we'll put over it some clay rendering and then waterproofing, and in the spring we'll place some local top layer of grass to cover the entire house. So at this point I'm taking down everything that is over the house, mainly that is straw and sticks from the flower that you can see all over the place. These yellow flowers are called rudbeckia, and those are the sticks that are on the roof, the rudbeckia stems. And as you can see, I already started, and this black layer, it's geotextile that is meant to protect the waterproofing. And underneath, if we can see it, is this waterproofing membrane. We'll get to this wood board. And for now, the project is to take everything down, at least everything that is on top of the main room, which is the highest, so we can take the insulation and everything to get at the wood board. But to do that, we have to take this with straw down. The straw, I don't know what we'll do with it, but I know that we'll have to clean it all up for the next 2 days. Also, until the straw comes, I'll show you in a moment. Okay, so what we'll have to do until the straw comes, it's from the edge of the house until the overhang. We have to replace these wood sticks that were only meant to keep the loose straw and the waterproofing membrane, but that will not be good enough for the straw that we'll put over the house. That will be something like 70 kilos on 1 square meter. So of course these small sticks will not be good enough to hold everything up. So after we take all this straw down, we'll raise for the moment only the margin, only this overhang waterproofing. We'll cover everything on this area with wood boards, and then when the straw comes we'll place a perpendicular margin in here 40 centimeters high that will hold at the edge the straw bales, and then we'll start from the roof edge to build with straw bales. Okay, I'll show you in the evening how the roof looks when it's cleaned off, and you can only see the geotextile or the waterproofing. And when the straw comes, which are very big, they are 2.4 meters long, 1.2 meters wide, and 90 centimeters deep, and they are 400 kilos each, so they are pretty big. So we'll have to work hard and do it quickly, because we don't know exactly how much of this beautiful blue sky and no chance of raining we'll have. So we'll have to do it pretty quickly because I don't want any kind of water to get inside the house that has dried for the last 9 months. As I said, we cleared the entire roof of straw and rudbeckia stems, and now we restarted the work at the roof. For this purpose, we start to add planks of wood boards over the overhang that was never finished last year, and we cut each piece one by one and clip them and nail them. I have two nice helpers, Andrea, and where is she? And Narcisa. We are trying to put one long wood board on top of the roof. It's 4 meters long and something from 12 to 25 centimeters wide. We draw the contour that we want to cut. We cut them with a pendular saw and then we nail them. Let's see how it will look by the end of the day, when more of the work will be finished. Hopefully we'll have a nicer overhang. This is how it looks under the overhang. This is the place, these are the wooden beams that support the overhang. And this is how the overhang looks after we boarded it. Because at the exterior, in something 1.2 meters wide or more, we're going to add some perpendicular pieces of wood, so all the planks of wood will join together better and they will hold better the weight of the straw bales, since the straw bales are very well compacted and are something like 70 kilos on a square meter, so they are pretty heavy. Hello, Andrea. How are you?
Great. Enjoying the sunshine.
The sunshine? I don't see any sun. I see a lot of blue sky. So where is the sun?
I can feel it.
Over what? Over the black pond liner that we put on the roof that is very hot?
Yes.
Very well. So, after one day of work that we started not so early, and after a midday that was so hot that we had to give up, we made 1, 2, 4, I think, more than half of the overhang that is around the house. So we have only this area to finish. And now Andrea is placing back the geotextile, and then we'll put the pond liner and then the second geotextile. So it will be protected until the morning. So the last two straw bales are taken off the car and we put it in here for storage. I hope we have enough tarps to cover them, because in 2 days time it will rain, and for sure I do not have this much time to put them over the roof. But at least they look very well. They look extremely well compacted and have very well-defined dimensions. So hopefully in the next few days we'll be able to cover the roof with these amazing straw bales. That straw bale is something like 400 kilos. And as you can see, it's pretty long. This is 2.4 meters long. It's 1.2 meters deep and 0.9 meter high. Probably tomorrow I'll call another tractor that has a fork in front, so it will be able to go over the river on the other side of the trees and take them to the house, because I cannot store them in here. And I also have to cover them, so we'll see. Haha! Job well done. The last transport has arrived with the last four humongous 400 kilos straw bales. They are going to be taken from the trailer of the tractor that is there, and this tractor with a fork in front is going to take them by the side of this straw bales. So let's see how hard it is to move them around. Ta-da! So we did this 20 times and we have 8 tons of straw bales, very well compacted. A week has passed since we started working at the roof. We finished boarding the overhang over the south facade, and then we started building this vertical or perpendicular side that will hold the straw bales in position. For this we use boards depending on the position of 20 centimeters that are clipped to the overhang with this where is my hand? With this 3x5 bat, and we screw it with screws on the entire length, and then to obtain 40 centimeters height we used these narrow strips of wood to put them in in contact. Now we did the same thing to the other sides of the roof, but in here we only used 25 centimeters wood board, because in here the straw bale will only rest, and then this entire height from here down to there will backfilling with earth. So it will be a lot of work. Now the straw bales have been moved from the other side of the river, where they have been unloaded from that long car to the house. In here we have 10 straw bales, and another 10 have to be moved. They are pretty heavy. I said that they are 400 kilos each, so they are pretty difficult to move. We'll see how it will work, because from now on we'll have to cut them in pieces like this. For this purpose, I'm going to create a long nail made out of wire, and with that wire I'm going to put through some rope, and we are going to let's say put like this the nail, so it will pass from one side to the other of the on the straw bale. And at the end of the nail we have strings that will be able to define new bales in this long big straw bale. I don't know, it sounds complicated, but it's not. Maybe I'm not good at explaining this, but we'll show you in the next video. Until then, I hope everything will work fine, and we'll see you in the next few days. For more details, look in the video description, and hopefully in the winter I will make more descriptions about this project. Bye bye.